हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आफ्टर कवरिंग आवर फर्स्ट लेक्चर मीनिंग ऑफ वीएलएसआई, वी आर मूविंग अहेड विद द सेकंड लेक्चर जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन द वीएलएसआई डोमेन। दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लेक्चर आई विल से, बिकॉज इट इज रिलेटेड टू द करियर ऑफ द आवर स्टूडेंट्स, द करंट अवेलेबल सीनियर इन द मार्केट। एंड आफ्टर डूइंग दिस वीएलएसआई कोर्स, where will get the job and what kind of job opportunities available in the market. So let us start one by one. The various job role available in the market is RTL design or RTL front end engineer. Second most important role available in the market is a verification engineer. Third one is the application engineer. And fourth one is the physical design engineer. So we'll see one by one what is RTL or front end design engineer. So wherever the applications required to design a very specific task, so that kind of applications are designed by this engineer in a front end. So what is meaning of front end? So in a front-end design, the engineer uses the HDL language to design that product, or we can say to design that particular algorithm. Let us say an example of LED television. So LED television is something like a very specific application where an application specific integrated circuit is used for that particular application. To design that ASIC, the engineer is developing his algorithm, is all the product life cycle in the front end. So that kind of application designers required in a VLSI domain. So to verify or validate this application, we need a FPGA design engineer. So that is again second category in the front end design engineers is a FPGA design engineer. So what is FPGA? So FPGA is a hardware platform used to validate the algorithms in a real time scenario. The next type of engineer is a analog and mixed signal design engineer. So in real life, if you know, all our life signals are analog signals. To interact with the human, it is an analog interface. So but VLSI is a digital signal processing, or we can say digital domain. But to complete the application, we need a mixed signal processing, like analog as well as digital. So wherever we need an interface with the human or any other external environmental interface, we need this analog mixed signal engineers. So for example, we'll take an example of this mobile phone. So mobile phone is a communication device which has both the technology, analog technology as well as the digital technology. So to design this kind of products, the mixed signal engineers are required, where he should know the knowledge of communication, RF, we can say, or we can say analog design as well as the digital design. The next one is the DFT, design for test. So this is again comes under the validation of the front end design, where the engineer does the validation of the algorithm by applying the various test cases. The next is the custom IP designs. So there are various requirements in the market where people required their very special or very special IP design. This is very important, I will say, in the aerospace design or in satellite communication or in military applications. So military applications is very custom designs. It is very totally different architecture wise different. So that kind of applications are designed by these RTL front end design engineers. To validate or to verify or to port or to implement all these applications, we need a very good hardware. So to design that hardware, a very high speed design high speed hardware design engineers required in the VLSI front end. So it comes under the high speed board design. So there also knowledge of board bring up, implementation or usage of the various hardware platforms like FPGAs or SoC are to be used to develop this kind of boards. Next comes the verification engineer. In India, most of the job opportunities available in the market is a verification engineer. It has again different steps in the verification engineer, front-end verification, then validation engineer, then hardware plus software co-verification, then validation of the VDA tools, whatever the tools we are using for the verification or the tools used for the design purpose. That tool verification is also a very important role by this verification engineer. Verification of the IP implementation by using test bench, or we can say by developing a various test cases. Verification engineers plays a very important role in any product life cycle, because the success of that product or the reliability of that product is totally depend on these verification engineers. So for example, I will give an example of mobile phone. Let us say in our mobile phone a music player is playing a song. Suppose if by incidentally if we press two buttons like pause as well as the next button, so in that such a scenario what our mobile phone should behave. So like that, the verification engineer validates the product by applying this kind of test cases. So by applying these different test cases, we validate the complete product, and wherever it is required, again it go for the redesign or modification of the product to become a very robust product, or simply we can say it should not be failed in any situation. So that is the main role of this verification engineer. Next one is the application engineer. After designing any product in the market, we need to sell this product, we need to market this product, we need to give the customer support for these various products. So this application engineers plays a very important role as a marketing perspective. So they plays important role for the customer support, they supports for the queries, they resolve customer queries. So to become this application engineer, the engineer should have very good knowledge of overall VLSI design flow. Then come the physical design engineer. These design engineers comes under the VLSI backend technology, where the actual ICs are fabricated, where the actual IC or we can say integrated circuits are designed. So this comes under the VLSI backend. So this engineer plays an important role to design a complete integrated circuit technology. So what are the skill sets required to become a VLSI engineer? The basic and foremost requirement is the digital design. The engineer should have a very good knowledge of the digital design. Then he should be very good at least in one of the HDL language, for example VHDL or Verilog. To become verification engineer, in addition to the HDL language, the engineer should know the system Verilog, as well as the engineer should know the complete VLSI design flow, how it works, how it is, from where it is started, where it is ending, the internal small steps in the VLSI design, as well as the various design tools available in the market. The very important, he should be very much aware about the FPGA architectures as well as the recently new technology available, system on chip architectures, how to partition, how to use these architectures to validate the design. So these are the very basic skill set, as well as the engineer should have very good communication skill. He should have very good problem solving technique. This is very challenging domain where most of the engineers are designing a new technology, where lot of R&D efforts required, lot of futuristic thinking process required. So this is a very basic skill set required to become a VLSI engineer. So this is a few list of VLSI domain companies. We all know about these companies. These are the most of the MNCs company like Intel, Broadcom, Qualcomm, Xilinx, then all the chipset manufacturers like Microsemi, Texas Instruments, as well as in India, so many defense companies, as well as so many startups, small startups are also working for under this VLSI domain. Or rather, I will say, to support these MNCs, there are so many startups in the VLSI domain. They support design engineering, they support verification engineering, they support sales and marketing.